This is a video on how to use my layered SVG files with the Brother Scan and Cut software. So sometimes with my files, there are a couple of little extra steps that you might need to do to get them to cut out on your Scan and Cut cutting machine. Something that a couple of people have said to me is that when they try and upload the SVG directly to their machine, they get a message saying that it's too complex or too complicated and they can't open the file. If that's happening to you, what you need to do is open the file in your Scan and Cut software, so the Canvas program, and then convert it to an FCM file, which is the Scan and Cut's proprietary cutting file, and then upload that FCM file into your Scan and Cut. So I'm going to show you how to do that in this video. Another question I get from Scan and Cut users is how you ungroup all of the layers of my layered designs so that you can cut each color separately on your Scan and Cut. And again, I'll cover that in this video. Now, one thing I will just point out is I don't actually have a Scan and Cut machine. So what I've done is ask a load of my previous customers who do have Scan and Cut machines all of the questions that I had, and this video is summarizing all of their answers and what they've suggested to me. So I hope that it is helpful to you if you do have a Scan and Cut. If you have any questions that aren't answered in this video, please join my Facebook group. I'll put a link in the description of this video, but if you join that group, it's all completely free, and then ask your question in the group, you'll be able to get help from people that do have a Scan and Cut. So let's jump in to showing you how to open my SVG files and convert them so that you can cut them on your Scan and Cut. So this is a desktop version of the Canvas software. I'll also show you the online version in a minute. But what you want to do is go File and then Import from your computer. Find where you've saved your files from my website and then open the SVG file. And this is the one that starts SVG underscore in the file name. So make sure you choose that one. Now there's a little problem with my files quite often in Scan and Cut. I'm not sure why it happens, but the design opens really small. So you can see maybe in this top left, there's this little dot, and that is the design. So what you need to do first, if this happens to you, is make it bigger. The easiest way to do that is to zoom into your canvas. So I'm going to go to 250% and then scroll so that you see the very top left of the file. Click and drag a box around the design and then right click with your mouse and press group. And once you've grouped the layers, it means you can hover your mouse over the corner of the box with the little blue squares and drag it bigger. So I'm gonna drag this so it's nice and big and then zoom out again so I can see the whole of the mat. Okay, so now we need to split this into the individual layers so that when you send it to your Scan and Cut, you can cut out the colors one at a time. So click on the design and then right click and ungroup. And that's going to separate out all the layers. And now you can move them about to get all of the colors separate. I might actually need to make it a bit smaller than that. So I'm just going to undo, group everything again, make it smaller. And the reason I'm making it smaller in the group is so that everything changes in proportion, because you want your layers to still line up. And now I can drag all of these layers separate. And I have been told from Scan and Cut users that it doesn't actually matter if your layers overlap a little bit when you're doing this. So you don't need to worry too much about making them all completely separate. I'm just dragging these apart. So just the eyes to go. And then I'll put that one back there. You need to make sure that everything stays within the red dotted line, otherwise you won't be able to save it. So now that you've got all of these layers separate, it's ready to save to import into your Scan and Cut machine. So I'm gonna go into File, and then Export/Transfer FCM. FCM file. And that's going to then give three options. You can either export FCM file, and that will save the file to your computer. You could then put it onto a memory stick so that you could upload it onto your cutting machine. You can transfer the FCM file via the internet, so you can send it to your machine, I'm guessing, through the internet with that one. Or if you've got a USB cable to connect your scan and cut to your computer, you can transfer it through your cable. So however you choose to do it, however you normally work with files on your scan and cut, is the one that you'll want to choose here. And once you've exported the file or transferred it, then you should be able to open it on your scan and cut, and it won't show you that image too complicated or too complex message anymore. If you're using the online version of Canvas, then the process is very similar. So I'm going to make a new file and then click the button that says SVG on the top. So when you hover over it, it will say Import SVG. And then I can find the file on my computer. Just like before, I want to choose the SVG file, so it's the one that starts SVG underscore in the file name, and then press OK. Once again, this is loaded really small, so I need to zoom in and then select everything by drawing a box around it, right click and press Group, and then I can drag it bigger. I'm now going to zoom out again and resize this. And now I need to split the layers apart again. So I can right click and press ungroup. And then just like before, I can drag all these layers separate. And it doesn't matter if they're overlapping a little bit. But the reason we're doing this is so that when you load it on your scan and cut, you can delete the colors that you don't want to cut so that you've just got one color left, and then you can cut that color and then repeat the steps for the other colors. So now I've separated everything out, I can export the file. So on this one, the online version of Canvas, you want to press download. And then that's going to give you a couple of different options. You can either download the file to your computer. So if I press that, you see it saved that FCM file for me. Or you can transfer it directly to your scan and cut. Mine's not letting me do that because I don't have a scan and cut. So I clicked the download button. If you want to save this so that you don't have to make the same changes again next time you cut the file, give it a name in the top left and then press the Overwrite This Project button. And then that will save it for you. So now it will be available in your projects when you open the Canvas software. When you open this on your scan and cut machine, there's a couple of other things you need to do. If you haven't already got this at the size you want to cut it, then you'll need to resize the layers. I'm afraid I can't help out with how you do that on your actual machine because, as I said, I don't have one, so I'm unable to see how that works because I don't have access to the LCD touchscreen. For the scan and cut, I'm told that it only lets you cut out one colour at a time. So what you'll need to do is choose one colour, so perhaps the light cream one on the colours of this spaniel, and then you need to delete all of the other colours from the screen so that you're only left with all of the layers in one colour. You can then rearrange the shapes on your mat so that none of them are overlapping, and then send it to cut and cut out that one colour. You can then undo your delete or go back to the home screen and import the project again, and this time select a different colour and then delete all of the other layers. And then just keep repeating that for all of the colours in your design until you've managed to cut everything out. Okay, so I hope this video was helpful if you have a scan and cut and weren't sure how to go about using my layered files. If you do have any more questions, please join my Facebook group and ask in there. Or if you'd prefer, you can send me an email to sarah@craftwithsarah.com and I'll do my best to help you out. Thanks for watching. Bye.